Hey everyone, Michael Antonovich with Swap Moto Live. We're in France for the 2022 Paris Supercross. Two difficult years are in the past for a race that has influenced the sport tremendously over nearly four decades, and the Lariviere Organization has put together a talented list of riders for two nights of action in the sold-out Paris La Défense Arena. We'll go over some of the key details in this SML Newsbreak presented by Fly Racing. Access to the Paris La Défense Arena is important, as its location in the business district brings the action to the metropolitan capital, and its status as Europe's largest arena offers enough floor space to build a big track. This year's layout includes a 260-foot start straightaway, three rhythm lanes that offer lots of options, a standard triple with a stout landing, and a long set of whoops, an important feature that was absent in the 2021 track. Riders got a chance to try out the course on Friday afternoon, laps that you can watch in the raw video posted on our channel. Like we said in the intro, this year's rider roster is one of the best yet, with Marvin Muscan, Eli Tomac, Ken Roczen, Cooper Webb, and Justin Brayton among those in the SX1 class. For Muscan, the weekend is a chance to win a fourth King of Paris crown, an accomplishment that would put him even with French MX icon David Villeman. Alongside him in the Red Bull KTM pit area is Cooper Webb, one of the few American riders that has raced the Paris Supercross in three different venues. Webb and Muscan are aboard KTM's latest iteration of the 450 SXF, which has been redesigned to address the handling issues that saddled them in 2022. The riders spent weeks testing with the factory team in California and Florida, and this weekend will be the new bike's first competitive laps. Although there were hopes Eli Tomac would debut the new Yamaha YZ450F this weekend, he and Monster Energy Star Racing Yamaha have decided to stay with the proven 2022 package. The reason why is simple. This is the same bike that he raced as a wildcard entrant at the FIM World Supercross kickoff in Cardiff. Eli has been to this event a few times before, but getting him back this year is a big deal for the promoters, as they've only had the defending AMA Supercross champion line up three other times in recent history. Jeremy McGrath in 2000, James Stewart in 2009, and Jason Anderson in 2018. Ken Roczen and Justin Brayton were late additions to the entry list as they filled vacancies caused by Jet and Hunter Lawrence's visa-induced absences. Getting Roczen to this race has been a 10-year effort by the promoters, and this will be the first time that the German has raced a proper Supercross in mainland Europe. For Brayton, a rider known for his overseas success and a past King of Paris, this weekend is a chance to stay sharp between rounds of the Australian Supercross Championship. Both riders are aboard CRF 450Rs under the Honda Genuine Honda Racing banner. New for this year is an official live stream broadcast through mxgp-tv.com, which will show 4 hours of coverage each day, including opening ceremonies, every SX1 and SX2 race, and feature commentary from Paul Malin. Access to the weekend feed is $11.99. I was watching some old Paris Supercross races. You're quite the SX2 rider over here. Prince of Percy, what, twice?
In 2018 I was, and then 2019 I ended up second. So I've been here twice, and I won it once, and then, like I said, finished second. But I'm excited to be back. Excited to be back here in 22 and back on Honda.
That's right, yeah. So now back with Phoenix Racing after a couple years on Yamaha. This is a nice way to get back to it, huh?
Yeah, it definitely is. I raced for this team, Florent Richier's team, in 2019 when I came over here. And I came with like a lot of my parts and things like that. This time I just kind of showed up, brought my suspension, and it's been good. And then also I have Ben sheet metal wrenching for me, so that's super cool. Kind of the first time that he's wrenched for me, but no, I'm stoked on that. I have one of my good buddies here, Josh Cartwright, and I got a cool little support group here to help out.
For a racer, how is this one? You know, because it's not the pressure of like AMA stuff, but it's still a big one, and you know there's a lot of attention on you because it's the only race right now.
Right. Yeah, there definitely is. Just, like you said, this is the only race going on right now. And with just finishing up World Supercross, and I definitely had good speed there, but had some issues and trouble, so I didn't really get to perform there. And I've been working very hard and just switching over to the Honda. I have about a week on the bike now, but I feel good. Like, I've really gelled with the bike. We made some changes, small changes here and there to get comfortable, and I feel like I have a good suspension setting. You never know when you come to a race like this just because the track and the environment stuff's a little bit different, but overall, I think I'm in a good spot, and looking forward to kicking it off and get a ride a little bit today and do a couple little practice sessions, spin some laps, and then be ready to go for tomorrow and Sunday.
All right, like you said, World Supercross, did it with the club guys, yeah. SX2 then. What's it like? What's your thoughts on Supercross getting out there more and more? Because you see that there's fans out there that want to see it. It's just about getting it out there the right way, huh?
Yeah, I think so. I think the World Supercross thing is awesome, especially for someone like me. Like, I've kind of only been an indoor guy, you could say, since like 2015. So, you know, especially doing it on the global stage, I think is awesome as well. And kind of gives guys that, you know, say if you're indoor only or whatever, not opposed to racing outdoors, but just I've only done Supercross for many years and arena cross. So kind of being an indoor guy, it gives us a whole nother series, you know, a whole nother environment to go race, to do AMA Supercross, then go do World Supercross this year, just being a couple rounds. But, you know, next year they're talking 8 rounds or so. So I definitely want to do it again next year. And, you know, kind of be in the fight for the championship in the SX2 class.
Well, hey, have fun this weekend.
Yeah, thank you.
Your team knew everything. How is it? How is it to make that big switch?
Yeah, it's pretty surreal to me. Making the switch pro circuit, I learned a lot. It was awesome. Mitch was crazy good to me, and I moved closer to home, made the switch to KTM to work with Marvin this year, and couldn't be better. It's still so surreal to me that 11 years in this sport, and I'm still so excited every day to keep coming to work and seeing new people all the time, meeting new people and just everything.
So, you know, when we're at the races every weekend and we all know each other and we all see each other in the pits and everybody talks, I'm sure there's always like a wonder of, well, I wonder what it's like over at that thing. Because even for me, I always wonder like, all right, I wonder how these guys get along or what that rig is like. Is it what you thought? Is it different? Is it about the same?
Yeah, no, for sure. I think that every single time I go into the pits, and it's exactly what I thought. I've been fortunate enough to be able to go to the factory in Austria to build my bike for Paris Supercross, and it is exactly what I thought. From the outside looking in, it more was like a clean Formula One type looking team, and it's exactly held up to my expectations on the inside, and just everybody is very professional and mature about everything.
You didn't go to HQ first trip. I mean, that's a big one.
Yeah, going to Austria, also a huge culture shock. Nobody speaks English there, and the food is so much different, and going to the factory, the museum, seeing Marvin's championship bikes, and the whole history of the entire company of KTM is unreal.
All right, how is it to work with a guy that's pretty established? Like, his and Frankie's relationship is super set, so you know you'll still have Frankie there to rely on, but Marvin knows what he likes, so it's not like you're guessing and picking and choosing. They pretty much told you to do this, huh?
For sure. Marvin knows exactly what he wants. I also have to respect that Frankie was with Marvin for 9 years, and that they speak to each other a lot, and Frankie has been helping me a lot to adapt to this, and it's just maturity, and they know what they want and what they want to feel, and it just makes my job a little bit easier.
All right, Coop, good to see you. How's everything been?
Yeah, man, it's been great. We're here, obviously, here at Paris Supercross, and it's been good. Been grinding away, you know, doing a lot of testing with the new KTM, doing the training back at Alden Baker's, and we're here in Paris enjoying our weekend of racing. It's been a while since I've raced against the top guys, so looking forward to that. And overall, yeah, just enjoying it. It's good to be back with Carlos, my mechanic, and see where we stack up against everybody.
Hey, full Euro trip this week, started off in EICMA. How was that? I've been to it before, but for Americans that don't know, it's like a trade show on steroids.
Yeah, so we were able to go to Milan. Bell had me out for the ECMA show. It was a great, great time, man. There was so many people, it was actually insane. It was about 6 convention centers just full of anything motorcycle related you could think of. So it was super cool. I'd never been, and honestly, I never really knew how intense it was. So it was really cool to check out. Those guys at Bell hooked it up, and then, flew from Milan to Paris yesterday, and now we're here for the Paris Supercross. Was able to go sightsee yesterday. It was actually my birthday, so we able to have a good dinner and go sightseeing the Eiffel Tower and stuff like that. Did some press today, and yeah, should be a fun weekend.
Are you ready for them to sing to you for your birthday again this year, like they did in 15?
I'm not sure what they have planned. I know the Paris guys always do something cool for my birthday. This will be my, I spent my 18th here for my birthday, my 20th, and now my 27th. So pretty crazy to think of. And then we were talking about it yesterday. I've raced this race 3 times, but in 3 different venues. So pretty cool.
Well, you probably are the only guy of, like, maybe Brayton too, current generation, to go from that small to that big now too.
Yeah, we started in that Bercy Arena. It was tiny, racing through the hallways. Honestly, that one was super cool. Honestly, looking back, it was fun. And that was when we did 3 nights of racing, which when I went that first time, I was just excited. But I'm sure, you know, now I'd be like, man, 3 days in a row. But then went to Lille the second year, which was great. And then now, yeah, we're here at the new stadium, La Défense, I think it's called. And pretty good. Track's pretty good. Dirt's good. Good size. And 3 years, 3 different places.
Hey, you know what? I have to give you props. You try to say all the French words. Other people don't. You just go right through it. I like it.
Yeah, you know, you try to be a little cultured, not just that dickhead American.
All right, you said it. New bike. How is it?
Yeah, we obviously had the new bike last year, so. As you could tell with Supercross, and even for me watching outdoors, it seems like there was definitely some issues still. So it's good, man. We busted our butt in October to really try to turn things around. And all summer we were trying a bunch of stuff kind of under the radar, just trying to get a direction and fix some things. And it was great for me. You know, I was able to kind of have no pressure and just really try to gel with the bike itself and work on what it needed to be fixed. And yeah, like I said, I spent 2.5 weeks in California. I'm sure the guys got tired of me and how strongly I felt about getting some changes made, but it was good, man. The team's been working their butts off, and I feel like we're back on par to be able to compete and be champion again in 23.
All right, perfect way to test it out this weekend, huh?
Yeah, it'll honestly be great. You know, we've been riding Supercross for about 5 weeks now, and you know, been at Alden's for, it was exactly 2.5, with not touching the bike, which is always a great feeling. And then, yeah, we get to race some of the top guys. You know, Eli's here, Kenny, Marvin, Brayton. So it'll be honestly a real test. It's pretty cool. We'll be able to race and get a good feel, see what we need to do with the bike and where I'm at physically and everything like that. And yeah, I'm excited. It's been, like I said, it's been a while since I've had a proper gate drop. You know, I've done some local races, but it'll be good to race these guys again and definitely enjoying being here in that environment again.
Jamie, you've been on it lately. You've been racing everywhere. Australia 2 weeks, now here, England. How's it been?
Good. Yeah, kind of normal. Honestly, I don't know how long I've been doing this, 10 plus years or so, always racing in the fall, traveling a little bit. I love it, I honestly do, and with me not doing American stuff, you know, I would typically be like rushing home from here, try to get some training in, try to get some testing, where now, you know, pretty relaxed schedule as far as traveling back, or even while we're here, I don't, you know, I'm not going to the gym near as much as I would previously, and so yeah, been able to enjoy it. Obviously still want to be really competitive and be up front at all these races, so and that's what keeps it fun, really. But yeah, been enjoying it. Lots of travel, but nothing too out of the ordinary.
Mm-hmm. On the racing front, you know, when you have that much travel, it's not like you're riding as much as you are during the week, so does it make it extra important or extra fun when you get to hit a good track like this and know, like, hey, these are the laps that count?
Yeah, that's something, you know, that's been tough for me traveling throughout the years. I'm typically a guy that likes to ride quite a bit during the week. So when I would do the Australia stuff before, that's why I would move my whole family over there for 3 months. So we just stayed there. I could do normal program during the week. Where these, yeah, I mean, you kind of have to really just go with the flow, from food, workouts, even bikes sometimes. So I think it's helped me over my career to just sort of go with the flow. Early on my career, I would freak out if I didn't get a day of riding in, you know, during the week, or if there was some weather coming in and wasn't able to ride. So it's definitely helped me, and you got to adapt to tracks a lot quicker. And then adapt to really your bike setup. I mean, this weekend I've got a great bike, but sometimes in the past I'd come and just bring my suspension, and early on for sure I would just bring suspension. Then we got to where we're shipping bikes and all that and taking it real serious. But yeah, you definitely have to adapt to certain things, and probably the biggest thing is time zone. Try and get some sleep when you can, and just kind of roll with it.
All right, you got two more after this, back to Australia, Newcastle and Wagga Wagga. For people that don't know, I mean, this is on right now. You and Tanti tied in points. Adelaide was awesome. They got to watch, huh?
Yeah, yeah, it's a fun battle. Was able to win the first round, second at the second round. We'll see how the last two go, but just always enjoy my time in Australia. Would love to win a fifth championship. We'll see. The second round didn't quite go as planned. Really, really basic track. And hopefully they can build some tracks like this with some whoops and some decent rhythm lanes and make it a good battle between me and Aaron.
Cooper just pointed out that he's raced all three places. He raced Percy, Leo, and here. Did you do all three too?
I did, yep.
How different is it from the three?
Well, Percy's just, there's so much nostalgia there with the past, you know, there's so much history. So when I first got to go there, I think it was 06 or something, maybe 07. I just couldn't believe I was there. And then the fans are pretty much on top of you there. I mean, I think it was like 12 to 15,000 people. Three nights of racing, really intense. A little bit shorter track, like more of an arena cross style track, but the fans were just, they were nuts. It was crazy. Really, really fun atmosphere. And then we went to Lille. Lille was kind of outside of Paris, so where this vibe, where we're at now, is really close to downtown, which Bercy was as well. And I think that's part of the race. Like, you're close to the city. Like, we went to the Eiffel Tower last night, had a great dinner downtown. And this stadium here is awesome. Really, really good dirt, big floor space. I love how we pit on the floor right next to the track. Seats a lot of people, and the thing is jam-packed. So really three totally different ones. I would say, you know, the Bercy, which fast forward 20 years from now, this place is gonna have that nostalgia like Bercy does. So cool to was able to win Bercy, one of the last years they had it, 2009. So have my name on that trophy was really, really cool. But this is going to be fun, obviously, with Kenny and Eli, Coop, Marv. I mean, I was telling somebody, like, that could be your top four at Anaheim 1. So it's fun to race with those guys and ready to mix it up.
And they've been trying to get you to this one forever. So how does it feel to finally be here?
Yeah, they've been trying to get me here for probably about 10 years. But I don't know, where I was in the career, I just wasn't really the right time, right? But this year, obviously, since I've done some of the WSX stuff, it just really fit in, and I was really wanting to come here. So it's just refreshing, right, being here. And this is a big race. Everybody around the world knows this race. So it's just cool, and especially you have a lot of really fast guys here that are the top guys in the U.S. as well. And so it's a good matchup. You know, we are about a couple months out from Anaheim. But we had a little press day today, which is kind of cool. It's kind of Super Bowl style, you know. We're out there by ourselves, and each individual on their own, and the track's super tacky, which makes it interesting, right? Like, just kind of weird getting on the track, and with how tacky it is, it sucks the power of the bike down a lot, and also the spacing, like, in the rhythm sections, a triple, they're really big feeling, you know, so it was definitely good to shake the cobwebs off a little bit today before we go racing tomorrow.
Dude, the landing on that triple's beefy.
Yeah, it really is. That triple is actually really big. I cased it once a little bit, and it upset me a lot more than I thought it was going to be, just because you stick to the dirt so much, so it's definitely a big jump.
Like you said on the Super Bowl thing, I just sat up in the corner of the stadium and just filmed everybody's laps just now. That's cool to see everybody just get that time on their own, and then everybody gets to watch each other. Do you like it that way?
It's weird, but yeah, it was cool. I mean, you know, this is new to me, but if we were to all go together, we could definitely make this all a lot shorter instead of, you know, everybody doing four or five laps and then another time around. So it's time consuming, but I had fun, you know. It's not not like I got anything else to do, you know what I mean? So I really, really enjoyed it, and it was cool just to you know, watch some of the top guys to go around the track and kind of see what they're doing. And, you know, right now we're all doing kind of the same thing, but I feel like maybe we have a another quad section for tomorrow. But today, you know, for the day before we go racing, it's really just kind of get familiar with the bike, make sure everything's good, and like I said, shake the cobwebs off, and tomorrow it's going to feel a lot more familiar, so I think we're going to be able to play with the track a little bit.
Hey, like you've said so many times, like, this is a really interesting point in your life, and you're making the most of it. Like, I'm not going to talk about riding all the bikes and everything like that. but just to travel again, to go see all these places. Australia, you had never been to. Seems like you loved it down there. I'm sure there's going to be a ton of German fans that are coming over this weekend to see this. How is it to get back out and see some places that you maybe haven't seen in a long time or ever before again?
Yeah, I mean, it's not even so much places, at least coming here. It's all the people that I haven't seen in so long, you know, a lot of close friends and people that I've hung out with, you know, 10 plus years ago, and they're all going to be here, and that's what makes this race really cool.
Yeah, probably like a little extra boost, like home race now.
Yeah, no, absolutely, and it's a lot of people that I raced actually in the GP class and things like that, and since this is, you know, what, pretty much the biggest race in Supercross race in Europe, it seems like everybody kind of funnels here, and I heard the stadiums are sold out, so it's just going to be a cool atmosphere, cool event.
Do you know a lot about this one? I mean, obviously,
German kid. Yeah, I've watched it in the past.
Okay, so like, you know all the nostalgia. Is there one thing about tomorrow night that you're really excited to see play out?
I mean, no, there's nothing in particular. I know it's going to be a lot of riding, which is great, especially for the where we're at in the season, right? Like, racing is the best practice you can get. So for us, getting a lot of track on the time will be good for our fitness.
You know, for a soon-to-be retired guy, maybe, you are sending it out there.
Yeah, you know, I'm feeling good. This is actually my first time ever in Paris racing this event. So super excited. It's a fun one. So really looking forward to the two-day race. And, yeah, I mean, I know I'm retired, but, yeah, still the year's not over.
How is it with the Bud guys? Like, again, now you'll see the full scope of their powerhouse French team. They've had a bunch of Americans come over here before, but this weekend, like, you're the guy, you and Moss.
Yeah, it's been good. The Bud Racing team has been awesome, fun to work with. A little difficult with the language barrier, but other than that, it's been good. The team's been solid, so just looking forward to, you know, two good days of racing. I got Matt Moss as my teammate again, so yeah, it's going to be a lot of fun and looking forward to it.
Okay, like you said, first time here, but obviously you know a lot about this one, so what was your expectations coming in, and what have they been so far?
Yeah, expectations coming in, man, I really didn't know, to be honest. Like, obviously, I watched it, God, for 15 plus years, and this is their 39th, I believe, race, Paris race, so super cool to be a part of that. But no, it's been cool. We got to walk around last night and kind of see the tower and some other stuff, so that was a lot of fun. And just looking forward to, like, getting out, experience everything here in Paris, and just trying to take it all in and enjoy it while I'm here.
Okay, I have one last thing to ask you, and this goes all the way back to Cardiff. When you said you wanted a trophy and you had to bring it home, how hard is it to take a trophy through airport security like that?
That one wasn't too hard to take through security. I made a bunch of room in my bag and covered it with a bunch of, like, gear and stuff like that so it wouldn't get too smashed. But yeah, I was able to check that one on the bag and I didn't have to carry it through. But I've carried big trophies through the airport before, and people kind of look at you funny, and like, you put in an overhead bin and you hear it sliding around up there, and yeah, it gets a little dicey sometimes. But yeah, hopefully we can bring another one home this weekend.
I got to give you props. Down in Australia, you rode a YZ450 one night and then jumped back to the 250. Been a 250 specialist all year. How's it been to go back and forth like that?
It's been tough, like, especially our race last weekend. Australian titles on the Yamaha, and then had to train this week on a Kawasaki 450 and then come home race the 250. So it's been tough, but, you know, I'm enjoying it. I'm enjoying the ride at the moment, so that's all that matters.
How is the back and forth between two different brands of motorcycle?
It's tough. It would be fine if it was the one brand back from 450 to 250. That doesn't bother me. But, the Yamaha to the Cowie, it's a big difference. So it's actually harder for – it's easier for me to get back on the 250 than it is so much to get back to the 450.
Just because of the power and everything?
Power, and it just – the Yamaha's like a real – you sit in it, and they're so much wider. So it's a struggle to get you moving again.
Yeah, I couldn't think of you finding two more different bikes to ride on two different days.
Yeah, typical me. I'll do it the hard way.
The one thing I saw, though, down in Australia that I thought was cool, I mean, you're the guy again. Like, a lot of Aussies are really pulling for you now that you're Mossy and you're older and you've been around forever. It's cool to see at this stage in your career and at this stage of your life that you're still dicing it up like that. Like, you went for the whole shot in that main event on Friday night.
Yeah, I mean, I'm just enjoying it. I'm loving it. I just... just gotta still get more races under my belt. Technically, it's really, I've only raced Supercross 6 races in the last 6 years, so I've just gotta get used to doing that again. So just getting in the battle and believing in myself, that's always the hardest part after having so much time off, but I just love it. I love the sport, I love what it gave me, and I try and give it a crack a little bit. One more year, I think, one more year, and then I'll be retired, I'm too old.
Back in Paris, going for 4-time King of Bercy now. How is it this weekend?
Yeah, obviously really nice to be here. It's always a good atmosphere. I see my friends, I see my family, and we get to race. So it's always good, you know, the winter season. I did race Red Bull Straight Rhythm, but, you know, it's not like a track, but it's always good to race before going to Anaheim. I used to race at least like 2 races in off season, like Geneva, but this year it's like only 1. But it's good. It's good. We get to see how the bike works, how the shape is physically. So it's always good. Always good.
You spent quite a bit of time here this summer, like in France.
Yeah.
So is it nice to be back?
Yeah, I did 2 trips this summer in France, like 2 times 3 weeks. So it's always nice, you know. I've been in the U.S. for 12 years, so always 12 years racing outdoors. So always going back to France in September for a couple weeks, but yeah, this year not racing outdoors. I was able to spend more time in France, and obviously I was in France and they called me for Workers of Nations, so I flew back to France and got ready for that race, but definitely spend more time this year, yes.
All right, for people that don't know, like, a lot of people see this race and they hear about it. As someone that's raced it so many times and grown up with it, what makes this one so special?
I mean, what does it make so special? I feel like it's, back in the day, it was just like the race. Still today, obviously some years, it was not many good guys, but yeah, definitely back in the day when the Paris Supercross Bercy started, I think about even like before Jean-Michel Bell or Ricky Johnson or like the top guys, and then it would be Jeremy McGrath or Jeff Ward. I mean, there's so many names, but only a couple. And David Villeman was coming here, Ezra Lusk, like Carmichael, like it was all the big names. So I feel like this year it's really like more like back in the days where like basically like the top 4 or 5 guys from the US are here, like, or at least like 3. So that's why it's so special, because you all the French people here, or maybe like other countries, they can basically drive or fly here. Like, it's pretty close, you know, they don't have to go to the US, or like, they can see like Tomac, Roxen, Webb, myself, and other guys race. So that's why it makes it so special.
All right, first timer overseas, how is it?
It's sick. I'm taking it all in, and the roughest part was showing up at 8 a.m. and then trying to stay awake all day yesterday. I made it till like 9:30 and I was out. Like anytime I sat down, started to fall asleep, I'd get up, just try and keep going, but I'm enjoying it. Today we got due press day, and so normally, you know, get press day, 250, 450, no. Here, it's one person at a time. I've never done anything like that. Probably the most nerve-wracking thing I'll probably do all weekend, but it was a lot of fun. So I'll, my shock and, or my forks and shock a little soft, so it goes stiffer tomorrow, and I think we'll be in a good spot.
Yeah, I could see you working that out a couple minutes ago, like, yeah. Oh, okay, he's figuring out the Euro suspension thing, it's got to go all the way out.
Yeah.
But that, you know, it's part of it.
Yeah, that's the thing. This year, going into my second season, I got to be better at just like knowing my bike. Last year, being a rookie and honestly growing up the whole time, my dad, anytime I go to the track and if I ever complain, he said, then don't ride. So like, I need to get better at trying to test and just getting better knowing what my bike's doing. So yeah, I showed up here and luckily I was able to bring my own suspension, but just the track's so different. Like the dirt is so spongy and sticky. It's like riding on glue. So I've been riding at Club MX and JGR's old spot, much different than here, but I think by race day, we're gonna be in a good spot.
All right, last thing, what do you think about being over here? How is it?
It's incredible. I'm just trying to take it all in, you know, like I can't even stop smiling. Like I'm in Paris racing a dirt bike. Like it doesn't get much sicker than that. Doing my dream job, and I'm enjoying every second of it. And also I got to have my brother and sister come with me, so it's like a little siblings trip to Paris. First time ever out of the country, and this is sick. And Eric Sorby's been telling me like how good the show is here as well, so like come night show time tomorrow night, it's gonna be like crazy. He said like I guess it's already sold out, so that's so sick to me. Like that stuff gets me so fired up, and I'm just sitting there like in staging just like geeking out. So yeah, I'm so stoked to be here.
That's it for this one. Be sure to follow our Weekend at the Races through our social accounts, our YouTube channel, and of course, SWATMotoLive.com. Talk to you soon.